cup of milk, 5 cubes of ice, a half of a teaspoon of vanilla extract, and the directions say you stir the peanut butter and jelly together in a bowl until smooth. Blend the milk, ice, and vanilla extract in a blender for 30 seconds. Add the peanut butter mixture and continue blending until smooth, just about 30 seconds more. So as you can see, a very simple recipe. You don't need very many things. 3 tablespoons peanut butter, as we said, 3 tablespoons of the jelly, 1 cup of milk, 5 cubes of ice, and the half teaspoon there of vanilla extract. Just stir the mixture together until smooth and then blend the ice with the milk, the vanilla extract, to the peanut butter and jelly in the blender for 30 seconds until the mixture is smooth. And you can add whipped cream if you like, that's optional. You can put it at the top to make it a treat for your kid before they head off to school. That's it for our healthy lifestyle segment this morning. Stay with us, we're gonna take a break and we'll be back with our celebration segment. To you if you are celebrating a birthday today, August 28th. Of course, from all those of us here at GIS Spice Morning, we always like to wish you the very best day. We hope that you enjoy it with your family members and friends. It is August 28th. We have some other famous persons born on this day sharing your birthday with you if you are born today. The first is Jack Black, the movie actor. He is the actor, comedian, voice artist, producer, and musician who was nominated for a Golden Globe Award for Best Actor for his role in School of Rock. He had additional roles in Tropic Thunder and Nacho Libre. He was born on August 28, 1969 in California. That's Jack Black you're seeing there on your screen. He's 45 years old today. Another famous person born on this day is Shania Twain, the singer. She's the Grammy Award-winning singer and songwriter whose 1997 album, Come On Over, became the best-selling studio album of all time by a female artist. She was born on August 28, 1965 in Canada. Shania Twain is 49 years old today. And finally, another famous person born on this day is Leanne Rimes, the country singer, another very famous singer. She's the country singer who covered the multi-platinum single Blue at the age of 13 and was considered the youngest country star since Tanya Tucker in the early 1970s. She was born on August 28, 1982 in Mississippi. Leanne Rimes is 32 years old today. And as always, before we wrap up this category, our celebration segment, we like to share with you something noteworthy that happened on this day in history. On August 28, 1963, during a march on Washington for Jobs and Freedom, the Reverend Martin Luther King Jr. gave his I Have a Dream speech at the Civil Rights Rally in Washington, D.C. More than 200,000 people attended, and this is still known and recognized as one of the greatest speeches of all time by a political leader. So that happened on this day, August 28th, in 1963, in Washington, of course. We hope that you enjoyed the celebration segment. We're going to take a quick break. We'll be back with the rest of our program. Do stay with us.
Constructors help in a big way to build the foundations of society. But sometimes as we build, our bad practices ruin the very foundations we are trying to build upon. One such bad practice is clear cutting in preparation for building. Clear cutting removes more vegetation than necessary and exposes the soil to erosion and landslides. Now that I know that, I'll be sure only to clear the area that I need for construction. Let us value the vegetation on our property. Let's manage our land wisely. Stop land degradation and love the land that you live on.
A message from the Sustainable Land Management Project, Ministry of Agriculture, with funding provided by the Government of Grenada, Global Environment Facility, and the United Nations Development Programme.
There is still a place where untouched beauty meets soothing experiences and a warm people. It is a place where cascading waterfalls meet quiet meandering rivers to join silky stretches of white sand beaches. A place where you are greeted with the friendly smiles of the local people, while the rich aroma from the abundance of tropical fruits, fresh herbs and spices fill your lungs. A place perfect for curious minds. Minds intrigued by 18th century plantations, a water-propelled rum distillery, historical forts, and petroglyphs that are still visible today. A place where you can go turtle watching, feed mana monkeys, and marvel at water-filled craters created from extinct volcanoes. This place also allows you to enjoy perfect year-round sailing conditions while diving the world's first underwater sculpture park. This charming place is neatly situated in the Southern Caribbean and is popularly referred to as the Spice Islands of the Caribbean. These islands are Grenada, Carriacou, and Petite Martinique. So come visit us as we take you on a journey like never before. Come experience the rhythms of spice.
Viewers, we have our first guest for the morning in the studio with us. It's Ms. Roslyn Otway, the Administrative Coordinator from the Caribbean Agency for Media Services. Good morning and welcome back to the studio.
Good morning, Ms. Carter. It's nice to be back here again this morning. Good morning, Grenada. It's nice to be here to address you this morning and to let you know what's happening at Caribbean Agency for Media Services.
Also known as CAMS.
Also known as CAMS.
So for our viewers that may have missed your last appearance on the program, can you let people know exactly what CAMS is, what services do you offer to Grenadians?
Caribbean Agency for Media Service, as it's called, is a media service provider. We not just provide media services, but we do training also in basic journalism, public relations and promotions, and advocacy.
Okay. Now, you have different courses at different times of the year. September is almost upon us, and you're going to have a new set of courses starting off. So tell me what courses will be offered in September.
It's my pleasure to do so, because this morning, the courses that we are offering from September, I'm proud to let the public know that this is a first time to us, but as our mission statement says, we train for empowerment, we educate for knowledge, to prepare you today for sustainable employment tomorrow. And as usual, our focus is on training for your development. So this morning, the training is going to be focused in September on CXC classes.
Okay.
For students that would like to improve themselves academically.
Okay. So for this September, it's CXC alone. Classes. Those are the only courses that you'll be giving.
Well, for September, but then we have something else coming up in October that I will speak on afterwards.
Okay, good.
But like I said, it's a first time to CAMHS, mm-hmm. but we are in the field of education. So I must say that we are quite qualified to do what we are setting out to do from the 15th of September.
So classes start off on the 15th of September.
Yes, it is.
What are some of the CXC classes that you'll be covering, or is it general? Or do you have specific classes like
math? Yes, we have specific classes. We will be doing mathematics, mm-hmm. English language, what people call English A, mm-hmm. Social studies, human and social biology, and principles of business.
Okay. So if there's a parent looking on now and they know that their child is probably having difficulties in one of these subject areas and they would like to take the classes, how can they go about registering?
Well, they can come into our center on St. John Street at CAMHS Training and Advocacy Center. We have opened up an office on St. John Street, upstairs the ultrasound services, right opposite the daycare and preschool on St. John Street. It's called CAMHS Training and Advocacy Center. The home of opportunities.
Very conveniently located now.
Yes, it is actually in an ideal location.
Okay.
And the prices are right.
So let's talk about prices. How much does it cost to take part in one course, or do you have a package where you can take all of the CXC courses that you're offering? Tell me the package.
Well, it's like $25 for registration, mm-hmm. and you pay $50 per month for each subject. However, if you want to do all five subjects, we'll give you at a discounted price.
Discounted price. Excellent. Yes. And who are the professors that will be teaching the classes?
We have Miss Nikisha Lalji. Mm-hmm. She's from Karaku, okay. but she's living in Grenada, I know. Then you have Miss Indra Thomas. You have Miss Claire Briggs and myself. Rosalyn Otway.
That will be teaching classes to
yes,
the students.
Yes.
So if persons would like to get in contact with you, they contact CAMHS directly.
Yes, they can call 407-4597 or they can visit our office on St. John Street, upstairs the ultrasound services, and come in and fill out the registration form. We have registration forms prepared, so they can come in and fill out the forms or call me 407-4597 for more information.
Okay. Thank you so much.
You're welcome, Ms. Carter.
Ms. Otway. Now, for September, as you said, this is the first time that you're doing CXC classes, and everything is focused on the students for this September.
Yes.
But tell us some of the classes that CAMHS usually offers, for instance, what you offered back in June, and what you will be offering in October.
Yes. We usually do news and current development, current affairs development. We do publishing and profiling, documentation, research, you know, training in journalism. So persons with an interest in journalism can come to us for the training.
Yes.
And then coming up in October, we are also offering an alternative focus, what we call an alternative focus, a work study program,
okay.
which is a job seekers initiative. We call it an alternative focus. Well, students who have not been very successful at the CXC examinations this year, they can come in, if they have not decided to go back to their secondary schools, instead of sitting at home, they can come in to us. We take them in at a minimal cost of $150.